One moment here. Hey, everyone. Hello. That's all right, I think. Hang on. Might be a little better. Hang on a moment here. Hello. Let's see. Let me pull up this so I can see the chat somewhere else. Why are people saying I'm moving? Why are people saying that? I have no idea. Hang on a moment here. Oh, I was frozen? Why was it frozen? Hope it's not frozen now.
It's not frozen now.
No, I can see myself and hear myself.
It's not frozen now. No, I can see.
Okay. Okay. Hello, everyone. Let me just check something here. We gotta try some stuff out tonight. Give me one moment, please. One moment, please. Okay, hello everybody. Hello everybody, we have a key is here from Twitch. I can like check on my phone about Twitch. Hedy Silovitz is here. Constant Creek Freedom, Dodger Blue, Lego Mike, Biz Ferrets, Stinky, Meg Swede, Cruella, Reflections, Marzell. Christine Atherton, Rosemary Randolph, Kinetic, Can Aiken, AJ is modding, thank you. Raven Riley is modding. Ben is here on Twitch, hello Ben. It's happening, Polly. Dizzy Dale, Heidi Ho, Texas Snack Pack. Here is the, why is this? Oh. Sarah is modding. Hello, Sarah. Annie Cush is here. David Green, I think, is modding. Gino the Gnome is here. Daddy Dino. Bubba Twitcher, Dobby Nader, Nixa. Oh my gosh, Polly gave 20 of you memberships. Wow, look at Polly throwing around memberships. Thank you, Polly. He gave memberships to Evelyn in Maine, Marissa Pugliesi, Hedy Silovitz, Can Aiken, Game Slayer, Luann Branham, Ryan the Gamer, Deb Brigham, Marge, Stephen Morgan, Sarah, Veronica Singleton, Pat, C. Prowse, Renee M., Marion, Adam 187, Mary Stewart, Lunali Syria, K-Jack, Teresa Moulton, they all got memberships from Polly. Thanks, Polly. It's very nice of you. Very nice of Polly. We got a whole thing to do here tonight. We got a whole thing to do here tonight. We got some work to do during this stream. I have to see how this goes. I have no idea how this is going to go. Why is this thing like this? Lego Mike is here. Kay Body is moderating. Hey, Kay. Oh my gosh, Janet Burnett did the same thing. Janet just gave 20 memberships. Wow. Look at all the new members. Thanks to Janet. Beryl Kubler, E.T., Frank McLeod, Seashell, Miss Chrissy, Bobby, Tulane Trucking, Long Knives, Blue Tulips, Tyler Edwards, Jessica Sisson, Sharon Moore, Veronica Tovar, Polly M., Donna Branca, Michelle Wall, on the sidelines, Luke Elliott, Suzanne Walsh, Karen Belial. They all got new memberships thanks to Janet Burnett. Wow. Thank you. K&G Landscape Maintenance is here. Thanks so much, Janet and Polly. We have some work to do here this evening. Gonna have to see how this all goes tonight. No, we're not on the new camera. We're on the phone right now. This is the phone. We're gonna try out the new camera. Is it snowing? No, we got a really small amount of snow. We got mostly rain the last couple days. Eddie Holner is here. Oh, thanks to Donna Smith for the sticker. Wow. Thanks, Donna. It's really nice of you. So nice of Donna. One of our viewers just said they had a soda stream like I do. There it is back there. There's the soda stream. Magria Spirit Cat is here. Dobby Nader says, will you do a stream about the Israel-Iran situation? If there's big news in the Iran-Israel situation, I will do a stream about it. Oh my gosh, Geraldine Karstensen just gave memberships. People are just giving gift memberships. They're flying around there in the chat. Nick Shorts, BB Remix, Demetria Jackson, British Chippy, Angie, Alexi K, Pink Rose, 84, Colleen Walsh. They all just got gift memberships from Geraldine. Thanks, Geraldine. Jeez. Lois Cox is here, by the way. Annie Cush is here too. I've gotten so many messages today from people, which are people sending me just like clearly false clickbait posts by social media accounts claiming that Iran is bombing Israel, when in fact it's just not happening. I mean, it could happen, but it's like this explosion of just obviously false clickbaity posts. If Iran is attacking Israel, the only account that knows about it is probably not going to be this weird, random account that most people have never heard of, and that is not like an established news outlet or even a well-known news reporter. You'll know. Exploring with the Zuinos is here. 207 Genfa is here. Jeff Hulk Kemp is here. John 1948 is here. Lynette is here. GGNYC, Biz Ferrets, hello everybody. So we have some things we need to do here during this stream. I'll explain in a second. Bruce Mack, this is the this is the cell phone, this is not the new camera. But I'm glad people like the way it looks. This is the cell phone. We're in the kitchen. Darren Markley is here. RS Pat is here. Oh, I just found a post. A person I follow from BBC, Cheyenne Sardarizadeh, said, this video is being widely shared tonight with false claims it shows an Iranian missile attack on Israel. In fact, it is from Crimea. So I just reposted that. JK said the volume is good. Good. Okay, so what we're going to do tonight is the following. Next week, as many of you know, hello, Joner Games and Grass Valley Greg and Run Eddie, by the way, and Darvish, and Texas Annie. Next week, I am supposed to go on a little trip, and I'm basically supposed to go to Florida for a week, roughly speaking. Although I will have my laptop with me. That's pretty relevant for this stream. So we're going to be doing on this channel some kind of maybe outdoor streams in Florida. But, you know, when I travel, I bring my laptop with me in case there's big news so I can do agenda-free TV stuff when I travel, right? Because I don't know when big news is going to happen, so I want to have my laptop with me. And I've been a bit dissatisfied with when I use my laptop, the lighting in the camera. So I have this old webcam I've been using with my laptop, like 8 years old. And the lighting I've been using is pretty bad too, these two little ring lights. So I have here, I bought myself a new web camera. It just came out a few weeks ago, Logitech MX Brio. So we're going to try this webcam. And I bought a new light, coincidentally also a Logitech. This light right here, the Logitech, what's this called? Litra Beam light. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to attach both of these to my laptop, this light and this camera. And we're going to do a test stream. So while I'm on this stream talking to you guys, I'm going to post an unlisted test stream via the laptop. And you guys will be able to watch the test stream and we'll see how it looks basically and sounds. What I'm going to do is I'll eventually turn off the lights in this room and kind of up to approximate like bad lighting, then I'll turn this light on and see how we can get by with just this light. So that's the plan. The plan is to try out the camera and the light. And now the camera, I'm going to have to like install the camera. Although I don't, you know, maybe there's like a lot of software you can like mess around with and stuff. But I'll try to not take that long to put the camera up. And why is the light so wide? Because it's got to light me up. If it's just a little narrow light, then only a little part of me will be lit up. You want wide so you can light me up. Also, it needs to separate me from the background, because what the computer does is the computer will black out the background and replace the background. So I'm hoping that the light can do a decent job, but I don't know how it's going to go. Hey, thanks Red Squirrel for gifting a membership to Eddie Holner. That's really nice of you. Thanks Red Squirrel 82. So that's the plan. The plan is to try out. I have my laptop sitting in front of me right now. I'm going to put the camera on it and attach the light to it. I don't attach the light to it. I just had to plug in the light. I don't know where my light cable is. Oh, here it is. Here's the cable for the light. Yeah, so, and then we'll try it. I hope it looks okay. I hope it looks okay. So we're going to start that in a second. The camera seems wide. It's the camera from my phone. I'm sitting a little ways away from it. It's in landscape mode. Lori Sunshine is sad I haven't acknowledged her. Evelyn in Maine is here. I hope you have power, Evelyn in Maine, and you're not like using battery power. Dark Cloud is here. There's one air fryer there. There's another one over there. You can't see. Asia Sims is here. Really bad weather here the last couple days. It's been like this weird ice storm, slush storm. So I'm excited to hey DK79. I'm excited to get some more warm weather. Dances with Wolves is here too. Ruben Urban is moderating. Hey Ruben Urban. Yes, I am planning on covering the eclipse on Monday. I should have some footage from Reuters, I would think. So I'm planning on doing a stream on Monday for the eclipse. I'm not going, though. Stinky is here. Grotto Rabbit is here. So I'm looking forward to that, but hang on a second here. Oops. Why is this on top of something? Is happening here. Okay. All right, so should we try this now? Should we get into doing this? Maybe we'll start trying this. I think I'm going to put the camera on. All right. So my previous camera that I've been using, this is an 8-year-old camera, Logitech C922X ProStream webcam, which has served me well. But this is old. It's 2016 this came out, this camera. I think I got it in 2016. If not, then 2017. So this is an old camera, old webcam. And Logitech just came out with a new one. So I'm hoping that the new one, the MX Brio, Oh, I need to post the link to this in Twitch. I didn't post the links on Twitch. I posted them on YouTube in the description. The links are in the description, by the way. Hang on, I'm going to do this. Can I do this? Yeah, give me 1 second here. Let's see if I can get this posted here. Should take about 20 seconds. I forgot to do it. There's that. Okay, good. Good looking. Good. Good to go. Where's my description? There's the description. More. Got it. Okay, I'm posting in Twitch the links to the camera and the light right now. They're already in YouTube in the description. I mean, I can post them there anyway. So I'm going to open this camera now, and then I'm going to plug it into the computer, the laptop, and we'll see what happens. It's probably going to make me download some software or something, if it's not already on there. I may already have the, do I already have the Logitech software on there? Logitech. Yeah, Logitune. Dave in Bangor, Maine is here. People in, like a lot of people in Maine don't have power. Hundreds of thousands of people. We need to get our thing out here. I leave for Florida like the middle of next week. Going to spend a few days in Miami and a few days in Key West. And I am looking forward to being able to visit and do some streams from there. Tommy Bridges says, hopefully plug and play. If I can figure out how to open it, that would be great. If you go back and watch the news streams on Agenda Free TV we did from Paris, they just don't look that good. Never looks that good. Ooh, look, here it is. Here's the camera. I guess it's the face of it's a little wider than the previous one. I guess it lets in more light. Okay, it says, hello. Turn on your laptop. Oh, I have a stand for the camera, so I'm going to use that. All right. Where is it? There it is. I have this stand thing. So I'll put the camera on here, behind the laptop. That's what I got to do now. I don't want it sitting on the laptop. Hang on. It's a delicate operation here. Okay. That seems fine for now. Wonderful. Okay, here's the camera. Then there's this thing, which I think is like the mount. But I don't even think I need the mount. Oh, this is for like mounting it on your laptop or something. I'm not worried about that right now. I need to put this on. There's a little screw thing there. I should be able to put this right on the stand there. Just by screwing it in. Yes, it is screwing into the stand. It is now successfully on the stand. Breaking news, it's on the stand. I thought it was. Good. Okay. So the camera is there. Then I have to, I'll actually show you here. So there's the camera, right there. My laptop is down here, but I'll put it up next to the camera. But there's the camera on the stand. So the camera's there. The light is gonna go like somewhere near the camera. I gotta figure that out in a second. But hang on, I have this box in the way. So there's my laptop there. There's the camera. I'm gonna have to put the light like somewhere here, either above or below the camera. So let's just get working on this. I gotta get the camera plugged into the laptop now. So let's do that. All right, now, let's see here. I don't know why. What is that? Why do I keep getting, there's a weird thing going on. It's very weird. What is happening? On my phone, like there's like a headphones thing or something. Why is it doing that? Can you guys hear me okay? It's really strange. It's like I've never had this before. On my phone, like this, the headphones notification is going on and off on the top of the phone. Why is that happening? It's just regular on and off. Why would it be doing that? I have to like Google this. That's not good. It's really weird. It's really distracting. What is that thing called? The bar at the top on iPhones? What is it called? Who can remember what that's called? Some dynamic island. Yeah, it's like the dynamic island is coming on and off with the headphone icon in it. It doesn't make any sense. I've never seen this before. Why would it be doing that, such a thing? Should I try unplugging my headphones and plugging them back? I can try unplugging the mic and plugging it back in. Hang on. It's still doing it. It's still doing it. I don't know why it's doing that. What is happening? Tap on it? I've never seen such a thing. It's so distracting. It's like the headphones audio level or something. I don't understand. I can't worry about it now. No, nothing is open. There's no, I don't think I have any headphones open or anything. I'm not going to worry about it. As long as the broadcast is going okay, it's just very strange. You guys can see me and you can hear me. That's what counts.
You guys can see me and you can hear
me. Yeah, so I mean, it really is. All right, the new camera is not on yet because I haven't plugged it in. So I got to do that. Is this the thing with the new camera? Is this the cable? The phone wasn't doing that before. It's so weird. Okay, I gotta plug this into the... All right, I'm officially plugging in the camera now. I'm plugging in the camera, guys, right now. Okay, I think I just plugged in the camera. Nothing's happening, though. I don't think anything's happening. Oh, you know what? There's this thing on the camera. The camera has this thing where it covers over. How do I undo that? This camera has this feature where you can, like, close the lens. I didn't even tell you that. Hang on, I gotta look this up. I think you maybe have to twist it to open it. I'm trying to find some sort of, like, it doesn't come with a manual or a start guide or anything. And I'm going to the page now to see. Get started. It's crazy. Oh, okay. Download the Logitech software to customize your webcam. So I have to do that now. Open the, it's a privacy shutter. How do you open the privacy shutter? Oh, you twist something. Okay. I guess. Okay, I did that. All right, that's done. That's done. I opened the privacy shutter. This camera, if you twist around the front of it, I'm gonna show you guys this. Look at this. It's got this kind of thing on it. There's the camera. If you just twist this, see, that closes it. If you do this, that opens it. It's the privacy shutter. Now, it says I need to download one of two software things. If you're video conferencing, do this. If you're gaming, do this. Which one do I need? G-Hub or Logi Options Plus? Maybe G-Hub. I have to download the software for the camera. Give me one moment here. Let me do that. Download. And I'm just loading the software for the camera right now. Install. I hope everybody's doing well. Dennis says, my neighbor says he has one of these cameras. This is the camera we're trying out right now. It's new. So as soon as I get this camera working, we can do a test stream with the light, with this light and the camera, and see how it goes. I think it's $200, the camera. Same price I brought, I think, my last one for, like, 7 years ago or close to that. Okay, I don't care about this. Thank you for downloading G-Hub. Fine. No. Skip. Skip. No thanks. Okay, the camera, the program G-Hub, which is the Logitech program, I just downloaded the program, and it is now, it is recognized that I have an MX Brio camera, so that's good. On my screen, I can now see the program is showing a picture of my camera. So this is great. This is a good thing. Firmware update is required to configure this device. Fine with me. Install the firmware update. It's installing the firmware update for the camera. Updating the camera. Please do not close or quit this program or turn off your computer. Keep your device. So it is automatically updating the firmware for the camera. That is good. That is good. I'm on my phone doing this right now, not my camera. I can see the camera. There's a light on the camera. This is very exciting. There is life to the camera. So it's getting there. It's updating firmware, but it's working so far. And on my computer, it is updating the firmware. So far, okay. Let's hope this continues. Higher resolution on new cam. I think it's higher resolution capable, but I'm not going to stream any higher than 1080, which is what I was streaming before. I couldn't even get away with it probably, even if it could handle it, because usually if I'm staying somewhere, I don't have a signal that's really going to be able to handle outputting anything above 1080. You know, once in a while, people like say buffering or something. Let me say this again. If you're having an issue with the broadcast, but no one else is having that issue, it's probably on your personal end. So if you don't see anyone else saying buffering or anyone else saying like you're muted, it's probably on your own end. By the way, make sure you're watching at 1080. See, YouTube had me watching at 720, but I'm streaming on 1080. So now I have to literally choose 1080 in YouTube so I can see it in 1080. Make sure you are watching in 1080, even if you have to manually pick 1080. Okay. Updating MX Brio. Please do not close or quit. It still says it's updating it. Hey guys, it's been updating the firmware for like 2 minutes. Oh, hold on. It's still updating the firmware. This doesn't seem promising. Why is it taking so long to update the firmware? Yes, the firmware is updated. It's updating. The firmware update successful. Breaking news, firmware update successful. It updated the firmware. That's awesome. Okay. Wonderful. We're on our way, guys. We are on our way. Yeah, Bobtail says noise. Rob Zoso is here. Okay. Cynthia Moon, thanks for moderating. BZ's moderating too. K2, Ruben Urban, Raven Riley, David Green. Yeah, nothing really bad has happened yet. That's promising. Hang on, let me just handle this. Okay, so the camera should be working. MX Brio, okay. Okay, so now I'm on a screen. I am on a screen on the program where it's showing me myself on the camera, which you can't see yet. And it has all these like settings, like auto, I guess I'll leave auto exposure on right now. Low light compensation, I'll leave that on. I'm just going to leave everything on. I'm going to leave all the presets on. Then you can control the color. I have auto white balance on, so it's going to be handling the color. Focus, auto focus is on. Everything's automatic so far. All right, now I got to try another thing here. See if this works. I think we're very close to being able to do a test stream. One moment. Ooh, okay, I know what I have to do. To turn this off. Give me a moment. That seems encouraging. Okay, I think we're good. I think we're good, guys. I think we're good. Everything is working okay so far. Now I have to open up my streaming program and just get a picture. We're very close, and I haven't done the thing where I turn the lights off. A whole other thing is when I turn the lights off. Okay, so I can now see myself. Hang on. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is, I can see myself, that's great. I think I need to set up the test stream. So here's what I gotta do now. Well, yeah, KBN. So what I gotta do now is this, so I have the room lighting on, you know, I have the room lighting on, but I don't want the room lighting on. I want to use this light here, the Logitech Litra, what is it called? Litra Beam light. So I need to get this plugged in, which I'm going to plug this in right now. Where's the cable for this light? Uh-oh. Where is it? Did I bring it upstairs? What happened to it? I got to go get the cable for this light. Oh, no. Unless I have it up here. Maybe I never took it out of here. Oh, I have it here. I'm sorry. I was using the wrong cable for the camera. I'm really stupid. Okay, Steve is stupid. Breaking news, Steve is stupid. So I was using the light cable for the camera. So I gotta unplug. We're fine here on this stream, but what I need to do is I need to unplug the webcam and then plug it back in. Oh, the webcam actually is, that's interesting. The webcam is, now how is this going to affect me? The webcam is USB-C. So that's interesting. Because I think my laptop has two USB-C inputs and I may have been using both of them. So I may have to figure something out. But I have a USB-C adapter. All right, anyways, we're going to try this now. I think it's USB-C. No, here's one. Okay, I'm unplugging the webcam, and then I'm going to plug the webcam back in. The webcam is in. Now I got to plug this light in. All right, hang on a moment. One moment, everyone. One moment. Wonderful, wonderful, wonderful. Great, 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 great. What is going on here? What is going on? Oh, I know what, I know what's happening. I think. Okay, I think we're good. I think we're good. Oh, thanks for the memberships, Gringo. Hey guys, we're almost ready to do the test stream. Thank you, Gringo, for the memberships to Skoden Studis, John Reddy, Godly Love, PH Survivor 92, BA Jacobson, Jenny, Lee Charp, T Good, Dentine Miracles, Carolyn, all got memberships from Gringo. That's really nice of you, Gringo. Gringo, are you still in Mexico City? Are you in Mexico, Gringo? You know, I'm trying to, I have this long-term goal. I started this personal project of, I'm going to try to learn Spanish because I used to know some of it. I want to learn it well enough so one day I can go to some Spanish-speaking countries. So I'm actually working on it on the side. All right, so what I need to do is, it's not gonna happen anytime soon, but, all right, so we have this light. This light I think I can turn on now, just to show you guys. This is the Litra light. Woo, okay, whoa. This thing gets super bright. That's like, oh, that's less bright. There we go. Okay. All right, so what I gotta do now is I need to figure out how high does this light go up? I think I want this light to go above the camera. See, it's on a stand and you can lift the stand up. So what I need to do here is, let me get everything organized here. I have the laptop in front of me. I'm going to move the camera closer. And then this light, can I put it like right behind the camera or right on top of the camera? I think I can. It's weird. It's not used to doing all this. I'm going to show you guys in a second what I'm looking at here so you can see what I'm doing. So, check this out. So my laptop is down here, which normally I have open, okay? So the screen would be here. And there's the camera. And then the light, I think maybe I'll put right on top of it. I don't know if this is gonna work. I need the light in the camera. So the camera's on this stand, and then the light is its own. I mean, I can move the light closer, like there, but, oh, the problem is the light hits the cable. The light's hitting this cable. We can't have that happening. I guess I could move the cable. That'd be the thing to do. There, that does that. Now I can get the light closer. Now you run into, it's sort of pushing on the cable. All right, so you see what I'm trying to do here. I have no idea if this is gonna work. We're gonna have to see. No idea. All right, so I'm looking at the camera right now, and I have the light above it. Okay, so now what I'm gonna do, guys, is I'm gonna create a stream, and that for you guys to watch, an unlisted stream on this channel. I think I can just do another one on this channel. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. And it'll be on YouTube, so you'll all have to go over there. You can watch this one. I'm not gonna stop this stream, but I'm also doing an unlisted stream. That's how we're gonna do it. And then you guys can look at the unlisted one and you can tell me what you think. Hang on a moment. So I'm testing out the new camera and new light on my laptop for when I go to Florida in like a week. And I need you to help me test it out. Okay. What we're going to do is do an unlisted stream. So let me set an unlisted stream here. I'm going to set up an unlisted stream. And I'm going to give you guys the address to this unlisted stream. So go live. Schedule stream, create a new stream, test stream. Okay, I'm going to post the link to the unlisted stream now in the chat, okay, guys? So I need to post the link to the in the chat. So hang on. Here it is. I'm posting it right now. I'm posting the link. Oops. Unlisted test stream. Okay, I just posted the unlisted test stream. I gotta post it over on Twitch too, though. Let me post it over on Twitch. If I can. No. Are any of the mods watching on both YouTube and Twitch? Because that would save me having to post it on Twitch. If not, I'll post it on Twitch. It's just a little bit of a pain. See what they say. Oh, is the new stream on? No, I haven't started the new stream yet, though. All right, well, hang on. What I'm going to do is, guys, give me 1 second. I have to post. Hold on. I can do it. 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 Don't worry. I got it. Copy link. Hold on. Twitch, I'm going to post right now. Twitch, I'm going to post it for you right now. I think. Okay, there I am. I'm seeing, all right, so we haven't started the test stream yet, but I can see it's there. And now I'm going to say to Twitch, test stream, and I'm posting this in the Twitch chat, and I just posted it in the Twitch chat, okay? Okay, so now everybody, oh, thanks Haas McKayfabe for subscribing on Twitch. All right, so now what's happening is, what I have to do is, I think I'm going to turn the light on. I think I'm going to turn the lights off in here and then turn that light on. All right, I'm going to turn the lights off in here because I'm trying to approximate what the stream will look like when I'm on the road. So this is a pretty extreme case. Okay, so right now, the only light, this is why, the reason it looks weird on the phone right now is because the only light that's on me is the only light that's on me, wow, the only light that's on me is the bar light, that new light I have. That's the only light in the whole room. Is that one light, which actually isn't doing a bad job of lighting me up. So the question is, how is the agenda-free TV broadcast going to look with the new camera and the new light? Okay, that's the question. So what I'm going to do is, right now, is I'm about to start the test stream. Okay, so what I need to do is do it this way. It's a little bit complex here. Okay, I'm almost ready. I'm going out right now. How is this going to look? So I'm going to have you guys tell me what you think about it. If you don't know where the test stream is, go back up in the chat because I posted it a couple minutes ago. I posted the link to the. Maybe the mods can repost the link, but I posted the link to the unlisted test stream so you can see we're about to start the test stream. We're going to keep this stream up. We're going to have two streams going at once. This stream on the phone and then the test stream where I'm testing how agenda-free TV will look on my laptop when I'm on the road with the new camera and the new light. Okay, are you guys ready? We're about to start this. I'm starting the test stream now. I guess. All right, it says it's starting the test stream. All right, the test stream is live. The test stream is live. I don't know if you guys are seeing me in the test stream. It's not live yet. It should be live shortly. Yes, it's live. It's live. Refresh. I can see, I'm literally watching the test stream. If you refresh, you can see it. Now, this is interesting. Okay, first of all, it's very bright. First of all, it's working. Oh, I'm sorry. So, you know what's happening here? The audio is going to be messed up because, guys, so the audio is going to be messed up on the test stream. Why is the audio going to be messed up on the test stream? Because normally on the test, normally when I'm streaming on a gender-free TV and I'm on the road, I have this mic plugged in to my laptop. But right now, this mic is plugged into my phone. So if you're watching the stream, this stream on the phone, the audio is going to be great. I can't have the same mic plugged into two places. So don't worry about the audio on this stream that I'm pointing at right now. On the test stream, don't worry about the audio on the unlisted test stream because I don't have a mic plugged in. I can fix the sound. But again, I can't be using this microphone on the phone stream and the test stream. Doesn't work that way. So don't worry about the sound. Just worry about the video, okay? I don't even, can you even hear, is there even sound on the test stream? I don't even know if there's sound in the test stream. I don't think I have any audio. Maybe I can use like I'll use the mic. Try this. I'm going to use the camera mic and see if that helps anything. Can you hear anything at the moment? Oh, I know what it might be also.
I'm going to use the camera mic and see if that helps.
I'm hearing something. Sorry.
Can you hear anything at the moment?
Stop. All right, this is a mess. It's a mess. Okay, so I think you're hearing... Okay, sorry, there's a whole echo issue. So don't worry. You should be able to hear me now on the test stream, but the audio won't be that good because I'm not using this mic for the test stream. I'm using the camera mic for the test stream, okay? Right? So don't, again, the audio should be good on the phone stream. It should be not that great on the camera, on the laptop stream. But the most important thing about the laptop stream is what does it look like? So, first of all, if I'm looking at the laptop stream right now. So one thing to notice about the laptop stream, the test stream, is at least it's working. The camera's working. It's showing me, you can see the background. Now, there's only one light on in this whole room. So clearly there's an issue with, I'm kind of like too bright. I think what's happening is this. It's maybe if I make the light brighter, it might help matters or something. Let me kind of mess around with the brightness of the light. Also, I can mess around with the camera settings, but right now I'm kind of looking a bit washed out. I mean, it's showing me. I just bumped the light up a bit. The color doesn't look bad. Oh, make sure you're watching in 1080, guys. That's important. So YouTube had me playing it at 720. Let's see. So it's a bit washed out. Now remember, I haven't messed with any of the camera settings. I'll try messing with the light. I think what's happening is something like there's, it looks way brighter. So again, there's literally no light in this room except for the one light. So normally, you know, so what I'm trying to do is see if I can get by with this one light. I don't know. Yeah, I could maybe manually lower the brightness. It's weird though, because I don't know why. I'm looking at my streaming program and it looks much better on the streaming program. It's not that bad. It's really not that bad right now. Oh, see what happens? You know what happens? It's weird. It like, see, the camera is like doing this processing and it kind of goes from washed out to not washed out. You know? Yeah, Mimi says it's the auto exposure. So I don't think I can mess with that right now. I don't think I can mess with it while I'm streaming. But I have to do the settings on the camera before I start streaming, I think. Because if I try to use the camera software to change the settings, it's going to say it's in use by the streaming program. But let me just, I can experiment here now with the light. I can, if I make the light darker, oops, I just turned the light off. That doesn't work. All right, that's as dim as the light goes. And that's really a little light. I think with that, that's gonna be a problem because it's just so not bright. I think when the light's really dim, the camera's gonna try to bump up the lighting conditions. Anyways, that's the lowest the light can go. Yeah, when I lean back, it changes. Yes, you're right about that. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to bump up the light intensity. Oops. That's really bright. That's too bright. That's very bright. But how is that? If I just made it brighter, does that look a lot better? I mean, I could live with this. I just made it a lot brighter. What do you guys think about this? That kind of looks a bit better, right? Yeah, I think maybe what it does, people are saying this looks better. And this is pretty bright, but I think the thing is, I think what's happening is when it's too low, the camera is bumping up the light and it gets washed out. Yeah, now the color of my face, I feel, is maybe a little bit kind of yellowy or something. Hey, you know what I want to do? What I'm going to do, I look better on the original stream. Well, the phone is kind of washed out. The phone's washed out right now. That's also a phone doing its own processing. But, and the phone doesn't have to worry about removing the background and everything. So what I want to do is put on one of my work shirts. I'm going to put on one of my blue shirts and see how the shirt color looks on the screen, okay? So give me a second while I'm going to get up and you're going to see the background. And let me put on a work shirt and see how it looks. Again, don't worry about the audio on the test stream. On the test stream, I'm using the camera for the microphone, so it's going to sound crappy. All right, hang on a moment. I'm encouraged though. I think the light gives a good amount of lighting. All right, hang on guys. I'm gonna put my shirt on. What I need to do though is with this microphone, I gotta put the microphone on my t-shirt for a moment. Okay, you should be able to hear me. Oh no, you can hear me on the phone stream. Hang on, I'm putting one of my shirts on. Which one do I use when I'm on the road? I think I use maybe this one. One moment here. Hang on, guys. Hang on. I'm coming back. I'm coming back. I'm coming back. Give me a second. Let me just button one button. Then I can put the mic on. Okay, that's good. Okay, I'm back. So, see, what I want to see is if I could get the color right on my shirt. See, the color is, the color's a little off right now. I might be able to change that, but I also can mess with the temperature of the light. But my shirt should look a little, it's looking a little kind of like off. And I'm looking a little sort of like yellow. Let me just tie my tie for a second. Hang on. Give me one moment. But a big point of having the light in the camera was to make things look a little better. Because the color would always be off on my laptop. Like weird. And right now it's not really exactly where I want it to be. So I'm not doing a great job of tying my tie. This is just for the sake of for the sake of the test. All right, so I need to figure this out. Yeah, jaundiced, exactly, Grotto Rabbit. I look jaundiced on the test stream. And everything's on auto, though, now. That's the thing. Let me look up. Now, I can adjust the tint or whatever. Ooh. That's not working. It's weird. Which way do I want to go? See, it's like I'm trying to get it right. For some reason, it's like whenever my face gets better, the shirt gets worse. Why is that? I can't get it to the point where the shirt and the face both look right. That was a problem with the other thing, too. See, that's kind of how the shirt should look. Well, no, it's not really. That's nothing. The shirt isn't bad. The shirt is gray and blue. I mean, you can actually, if you look on the phone, if you're watching both streams, if you look on the phone, that gives you a sense of what the shirt looks like. My face is looking all washed out on the phone now, though. I wonder if... See, the thing I can do is I can go into the original software and start changing... I should maybe open up the original software. I don't know if it's going to let me go into the original software, though, because I'm now using this when I'm streaming. It'll say the streaming program is using it, so we can't use the camera. Let's see. Camera preview is not available. All right, what I'm going to do for a second is I'm going to try to, can I not, hang on guys, if you're watching the test stream, I'm going to try something. No, that doesn't matter. See, there's all these settings the camera has in the Logitech software, but I can't adjust those while doing a test stream. Ooh. Sorry, the lights off for a second because I'm updating the firmware for my light. Just give it a moment, guys, and the lighting will come back on. No, I'm not going to switch the color shirt. Lucky Minute thinks it looks good for the temporary setup. I think the lighting is a decent amount of lighting. I think there's a nice degree of detail. My problem is the color has been kind of off. Polly says maybe the blue background is playing with the look of the shirt. Sorry, give it a second, guys. The light's back on now. I just updated the firmware of the light. So, let me try one other thing. Camera settings. Let me just go into the settings in the streaming program. Maybe what I have, it's just everything's all, I'm looking at what you guys are looking at, and everything, the color, I'll say this. I think the one light is doing a nice job of lighting me, given that there's literally no other light on in this whole room. It's just this one light. So I seem adequately lit. For a laptop green screen setup, and I don't even have a green screen, it's just odd. The computer program is removing the background from me. So that seems to be working decently well. The one thing I'm not happy with is the color. I look kind of jaundiced and the shirt is off. And I'm wondering, I mean, one obvious thing I can do is I can, once I end the test stream, I can mess. There is software that comes with the camera, but I can't adjust the camera with that software when I'm using the streaming program, because it'll say the camera's in use by the streaming program. So I'm wondering if I can make some adjustments within the streaming program to try to adjust the color. I just tried that though, and it wasn't working that great. But I do think like there's a decent degree of detail, like given that it's the only light in the room. So the camera's at least working. Slug said the webcam mic is pretty good. I haven't even been listening to it. Normally, I'd.
The camera's at least.
Yeah, it's echoey because it's. Normally, I'd be using this mic with the webcam. Yes, no, the idea is that I'd be taking both the camera and the light to Florida with me. All right, let me try something. I'm going to try just within the streaming program, messing with the color some. There's brightness, contrast. I think hue is the one I need. It's just not, no matter what I do. That, I mean, right, that's obviously terrible. And that's terrible. That's more orange. Just for whatever reason, I can't get the shirt right. I mean, that's maybe a little better. A little bit. I'm still kind of yellow looking. I'm not even sure what I'm supposed to look like in the camera. Hold on. I want to go a little negative. I think there my face looks a little better, but the shirt is just kind of off. I mean, that's actually not horrendous. That's not horrendous. I just, the shirt on the phone looks much, if you're watching the phone stream, The shirt on the phone stream looks much better than the shirt on the test stream. But my face on the phone stream is very washed out. Yeah, the problem with this is the shirt is so off, right? The shirt's like green or something. It's very off the shirt. I don't know why I can't get both right. Why is that? Maybe because my face is lit up more than the shirt. The shirt is just weird looking now. I was having a similar problem previously. It also might just be, I can never really get it right. Well, I think the shirt, I do worry about the shirt. I'd like to have the shirt look normal if possible. I don't want to accept that the shirt will be of some weird color. I'm confused. Clearly the program or the camera is doing some processing to the shirt. The camera is eye level. I can mess with the brightness too. I can actually turn the brightness down. I just messed with the brightness a little bit. Oh, see, that's weird. Now the shirt looks somewhat better, but I'm like green. See, this is the problem. The shirt looks a little more true to color there on the practice stream, but now the problem is I just look terrible. I look like a ghost or something. That's not bad. Yeah. It's not terrible. The shirt color does look kind of weird. Tie color, let me see this. How is this looking right now? It's still green. It's like making everything look more green than it is. The shirt is all was too green. Yeah, I could try other shirts, but generally speaking, this has been the issue. The issue when I use the laptop has been either my face is off color-wise or my shirt is off color-wise. I also don't know, maybe I could raise the light a little more and point the light more down at me or something. I don't know if that would help because I can adjust the light. So I just changed the lighting right there. What I did is I lifted the light up. I don't know if that makes a difference. Now the light is sort of not right in my face as much. That's another way you can make an adjustment. But it's actually a little too down. Maybe a little better. Just for the fun of it, I'm going to make it even brighter. I just made it brighter. Let's see if that does anything. I don't think it did. Give it a moment. I can bump down the brightness some. Let's see here. That light is pretty bright. I will say this. I think the light works pretty decently. That's a little less there. I just turned the light down one step there. That's way down. Oops. Oh, I can also change the color of the light too. That's another thing I haven't done. Let's try that. That's as bright as the light goes. I think that's a little too bright. So that's that. What if I change the color of the lighting? That's a little more orangey light. I'm just messing around with the color of the light. That's really orangey. I don't want that. It's orangey or really bright. How about that? How about that one? That one's like kind of a good... I'm changing the color temperature of the light. I'm messing around with that to see how that affects things. It's not the worst. Interesting. See, the other thing to remember is it's never been, I haven't, what I'll have to do is I'll have to experiment some with the camera. What I should do, I should end the test stream. That's hard to end the test stream though. Because I don't have background, but I can mess around with the camera settings with the manufacturer's software and see like if I can do anything that way. Right now, Gas on the Brain says it depends on what light is coming off your laptop too. That's a whole other complicating factor. You know, there's that as well. So, but it's not terrible. It's not terrible. And I'll say this. The issues I have right now are with the color. It certainly is lighting me adequately. I don't feel like there's not enough lighting. And the color is not like horrible. So you know. No, I never had it. It was never the case that my face and my shirt were right. Mimi thinks it looks pretty good right now. Ruth says it doesn't have to be perfect. Yeah, it doesn't have to be perfect. In terms of being too bright, I mean, the problem is I can lower the brightness myself manually, but if I start lowering the brightness of the light, it's gonna be really low light in here, and then you get, then the camera starts doing stuff. Have I normally had other lights on as well? Sometimes yes, sometimes no. It just depends. It just depends. I just turn the light down a little bit. See, when I turn the light down, the camera makes an adjustment. So, and I like to err on the side of getting more light and less camera adjustment. I mean, it's not, look, it's something. I don't have it at the brightest level. I don't want to throw on another light in the room because I want to try to do this the way I would do it, the way I would do it on the road. That's the point. But you can see the camera making adjustments. All right, what I'm going to do, if you're watching the test stream, I'm going to end the test stream, but I'm going to keep the phone stream going. We're streaming on the phone here. And then I'm going to try to mess with the software. Okay? That's what I'm going to do. Hold on a second here. Kim says it doesn't look bad. Slug says it definitely works. Okay, so if you're watching on the phone, you can keep watching right here on the phone. If you're watching here, go watch on YouTube or Twitch the other stream. Okay, so let me get rid of, I'm gonna end the test stream on YouTube, the test stream. Oh, I missed a donation from Jake. I was looking and seeing if I missed anything. Thanks. I missed a donation from Jake. Hold on a second. What did Jake say? Hang on. Hang on a moment. I'll get it in a second. All right, I'm going to end the test stream now. So if you're watching the test stream, go over to the other stream. Okay, everybody who's watching on the test stream, go to the other stream. I'm ending the test stream. All right, I just ended the test stream. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to, if I can, let's hope this works. I'm going to open the camera software. Oh, I know what I got to do. Hey, everybody. Yes, we're back in the kitchen now. I'm still using the one light because I want to see if I can use the camera software from the manufacturer to kind of make things a little better. Yeah, I can't use the phone with the streaming program. It doesn't work that way. I can't just use the phone. It doesn't work that way. To do the news. The phone's not going to work for the news. I appreciate people's feedback, though. Testing 1, 2, 3, 4. Testing, testing, testing. Okay. Let me do something real quick here. Yeah, and again, I know I'm all washed out on the phone right now because I have this one light on. So what I'm doing here is, again, I have the new camera that we've been trying out here, and I have this light. I'm just using that one light. That's the Litra Beam light, the Logitech Litra Beam light. That's the only light in the whole place. That's it. And then the camera's right there. Kay, what did Jake say? Sorry. I missed a donation from Jake. Trying to go back in the chat. Okay, I am opening up the camera software. Okay, I'm looking at myself right now. This is so weird. Hey guys, get this, okay? I am looking at myself on the screen and I look fine. When I'm just using the native, oh, hold on, I think I got Jake's donation from Kay. It says, with the Logitech software, I'm pretty sure that even though you can't see the preview, you can still adjust the settings and the changes will be reflected to whatever the video output is being sent to. Thank you, Jake. I appreciate that. Maybe I'll try that. Thanks, Jake. Thanks so much. So guys, I'm looking at myself right now on my laptop. That is the camera software. And it's maybe a little weird for you because you're seeing this on my phone, but trust me, when I look at this, my shirt and my skin tone, maybe it's weird for you because the phone is doing things with this, but from where I can see it, I don't know, you probably can't see it, but that actually looks like perfect. So I think what's going on is, I think like my streaming program is making adjustments to, I'm going to fire up the streaming program again, but I think the streaming program was like making adjustments because I look much better in this window right here. That window looks fine. I'd be great with that. That looks very natural looking. So it's also possible I still had the old camera software on. Maybe that was messing things up. So I'm turning on the streaming program again, just to see what it looks like on the streaming program. Yeah, it's like the program does stuff to it. That's the problem. It's like the streaming program is doing extra processing to the picture. That's really what's happening. But I need to use the streaming program. I don't really have a choice there. Oh, I can, you know what? The camera, the streaming program was doing auto white balance, which I don't think I wanted it to do. That's interesting. I just turned that off. That's interesting. That looks a lot better. It actually looks a lot better right now. I'm going to do one more test stream. So the streaming program was doing auto white balance, which means the streaming program was adjusting the color on the camera. So I think that made a bit of a difference. It's actually good to know. What else is it doing? Yeah, I'm going to show you guys what this looks like right now. Real quick, I'll just do another test stream so you can see what it looks like now. Okay, do that. Schedule stream. Test stream 2, test stream 2. Unlisted, good to go. All right, I'm gonna do another. It's not perfect, but it's better. Okay, we're about to do the second test stream. Let me put the link in the chat for you. There needs to be a backlight. Remember, this is for when I travel. I'm trying to figure out a minimal setup that I can bring with me when I travel. So I want as little things to bring with me as possible. Okay, I just posted the link in the YouTube chat. I got to post it in the Twitch chat too. Hang on a second. I'm posting the link in the Twitch chat now. Hey, Yassine, over there on Twitch. David Green is moderating. God is My Banner is there. Okay to play all day. Magria Spirit Cat. Okay, so we're going to get the... Let's get the test stream going now. Test stream number two coming your way. Hang on a moment. Oh, Gringo gave memberships. Hey, thanks, Gringo. Thank you, Gringo, for the gift memberships. That's very nice of you. Gave 10 people gift memberships. Okay, I think we're good to go. Yes, we are ready. You'll see me in a second. There we are. Okay. So, first of all, I want you guys to notice something. So, if you're watching the test stream now, here's the difference. The big difference is that I turned off the auto white balance that the streaming program was doing. So I will say my shirt definitely looks better now. My shirt looks a million times better. Okay? It's still a little bright. Maybe I should like turn the saturation down or something. But my shirt looks better. Now, what I should do is maybe try to turn down the brightness or something. Again, the issue is not with the camera, it's that the program does stuff to things. Well, that's not working. Oops, sorry. Yeah, make sure you're watching in 1080p. All right, hold on. If I knock down the brightness a little bit. Now, it's not really a brightness issue. It's more of a, maybe a saturation issue. But saturation. Yeah, I knocked down the saturation a little bit. I mean, that's not terrible. It's not awful, actually. I mean, it's better than it was before because the shirt is at least looking like somewhat normal color, although maybe having too much color. I probably have too much color too. That's not bad. See what I just did? I just lowered all of the color. I lowered the saturation. So everything's the same color, it's just less of the color. That's not that bad, actually. I'm maybe looking a little bit yellowy or something. It's actually not bad. The background should not be interfering with anything. The background is its own thing. The background is a pre-recorded thing. This isn't terrible. This is not terrible. That's not terrible. The shirt and the tie are just way better than they were before. And remember, I'm not in a well-lit room, guys. I have one light lighting me. So this is not bad. Rob says, I can almost live with this. It's a big difference when you turn off the automated white balance from the streaming program. This is at least, this is livable to me. This to me is like, okay, I'm not like, there's nothing like super crazy going on. Wonka thinks it's good for a portable on-the-go setup. Jimmy was watching at 144p. Sorry, I had to get my water, so. Now, obviously, if I move around and stuff, the green screen will get kind of weird. It's not even a green screen. It's green screen effect. But, you know, just for, it doesn't have to be perfect. Mary DeFore says, you look better. It's what you see that matters. This isn't looking bad to me. It's not looking bad. All right. I could live with this. If we could get this quality on the road, I could live with this. You know that? Guys? And again, the sound is going to be terrible on the test stream because I don't have this mic running through the test stream. Okay. And it's, I will say, I look evenly lit. I'm looking at it right now. You know, I only have one light on me, but it's not like I'm like, oh, my face is bright and my and you can't see my shirt or vice versa. It does do a good, the light does a nice job of spreading out the light, so it's kind of, I'm lit up. You know, it's certainly not a perfect lighting setup, but it has one, I'm using one light. All right. I'm good. I think for purposes of going on the air when we're away, and you know, if it's during the day, if it's during the day, there'd be some natural light. This is just for more if it's at night and I have no other lighting. Wickedest Witch thinks the webcam and light upgrades are good. Wonka says it looks better than Paris. Yeah, Paris was not looking great. All right, I'm good with this. For the time being, obviously there's adjustments that can be made, but at least I feel like this is not horrendous looking. When I look into the camera, it's not that bad because the light, I have the light a little ways up from the camera. I don't want to stream like this every day, but see, the light is above the camera. So I'm really looking here. I'm not looking up there. So there's a little distance. And a lot of time I'm looking down at the monitor. And so when I'm looking at the monitor, the light's not in my eyes. So it's really not too bad. And I don't have the light on as bright as it can go. I kind of knocked it down a bit. So it's really not bad. All right, so what I'm going to do, is I'm going to wrap up. Yeah, I got to say, the test stream does not, I'm looking at that test stream right now, it does not look bad. Is it perfect? No, but it's not bad. It's not bad. Thanks, Gringo. Yeah, Kay, I thanked Gringo for the memberships. Oh, he donated more memberships. Oh, I guess I missed it. Hold on a second. Sorry. So busy here. Did Gringo donate 10 more memberships? Jeez, he did. Hey, thanks, Gringo. All these new members. Ryan, Portsline, Georgia, Sunshine Patriot, Juby Joe, What's Up Man, Danielle M, Melissa, Tokerchik, Ding Dong Dasher, Dark Cloud, Edget, Kalian. Nice. Kim Zink says it's better than past on-the-go ones. What I think I'm going to do is I'm going to keep the stream on the phone going. All right? Let me just check the battery on the phone. Oh, we're good. We're good to go. I'm going to keep the stream on the phone going. And if you're watching here, if you're watching our test stream where you see me with the globe behind me, go over to the other stream. Look Nerd on YouTube, Look Nerd on Twitch, where I'm on my phone. Because I'm about to wrap up the test stream. But I'm happy with how it looks, and I'm quite happy with the light. I think this one light does a nice job of kind of lighting me up. See, the other lights I had, I'm going to show you right now. I've been using two of these lights, and they actually give a decent amount of light, these lights, but they're not tall. So when I put these lights on the table, they're like below me. Like, if I put this light on the table, like it reaches like up to here. So the light is like, I'm looking, the light like comes up at me. It just doesn't look right. And I don't, and the light's not as good. I like this light. I like this light I'm using here, the bar light, better than two of these, even though these are lighter than that. I mean, this has like a stand and stuff. So I am liking this lighting. I like that I don't have to have two of these on either side of the monitor pointing up right in my face. Also, when these are on either side of the monitor, there's nothing pointing directly at me. Now, I don't want to use them all because I need to minimize the amount of stuff I'm bringing. I have to bring as little stuff as possible. So I don't want to bring these if I'm bringing the other light. This light, the big light, will allow me to leave these at home, which I prefer. The thing I'm going to have to do is I'm going to have to deal with the whole USB port issue, because the camera uses a USB-C port, and I'm already plugging into the USB-C port my microphone. Oh, I think I can use my adapter for that, I think. Yes, I have this USB-C port adapter, so I can should be able to plug this into the back of my computer and then plug the mic in here, and then one other thing, maybe a monitor is what I was going to plug in there. Okay. All right, so stay, if you're watching on the phone, we're still going. If you're watching on this camera with the globe behind me, I'm wrapping up the test stream. So go over to the other stream. If you're watching on the test stream, go over to the okay, people watching on the unlisted stream. Go here. All right, I'm wrapping up the test stream and I'm keeping the phone stream going. So thanks for helping me with the test stream. All right, how do I do this? I need to do it this way. Test stream two. We're ending test stream two. Test team stream two is over. Then I'm going to turn the lights back on. Take this shirt off. Okay, so now, all right, I'm turning the lights back on. Thank goodness. That's better. Wow, okay. I'm gonna turn this light off. See what happens? Look at the difference. Look at that difference on the phone stream. Now that I don't have that light on in front of me, see how I kind of look kind of dark? Right? So even if I put the light on a little bit, I'm going to put it on low. That's the lowest setting. Even that makes a difference, I think. Hold on. I go from that to that. That's low. So that's the bar light. Then you put it on like setting two. That's setting. I mean, look at that. Look at that difference. I'm looking into the phone right now, but you know, that to that. It's so funny. Makes a big difference. You don't notice it till you're not looking at it anymore. But yeah, let me show you again those two things that we've been trying out. That bar light that's it right there. It's this light right there, has a stand, and you can lift it up and down. You can actually put it vertically or horizontally. This is the bar light here, and that's called the Logitech Litra Beam light. They have another version which has lights on both sides, and there's a colored light on the other side, but I didn't need the colored part. So that's that one, and then the camera is this one, the MX Brio. If you're watching on YouTube, the links are in both of these are in the chat. If you're watching on Twitch, the links are in the description to both of these. If you're watching on Twitch, the links are in the chat posted a bit earlier. But I really, that beam, no, the light does not get hot at all. Actually, what I will do is, with that beam light thing, I can swing it over like closer to the phone and raise it up. See, now I have it behind the phone. Now it's illuminating me. Hold on. Which you really notice it when you turn it off. See, that's with it off. That's with the light off. That's how I was doing the whole stream before. It's kind of crazy. Then you turn it on, you're like, oh, I guess that's a lot better. The light is an LED light, yeah. All right, I'm just checking my... That light is actually a good light for doing these streams too, when I'm just in the kitchen or something. I hope nobody's messaged me about big breaking news, so hopefully there hasn't been anything crazy going on. Normally, if there's something really crazy going on, I get a bunch of messages about it. I want to take some more comments too. Thanks, Bruce Byrne. Bruce sent me some screen grabs. Thank you, Bruce. Oh, and then Miss Chrissy sent me the user guide for my camera. Thank you, Miss Chrissy. Let's see. Let me catch up with some of the comments. Crazy Audio says, now I get why Hollywood lighting experts get paid so much. Yeah, it makes a big difference, but also I'm using, you know, with one light, it's kind of tough. But it's helpful. Even for streams in the kitchen, I think I'm better off using this light in here. To supplement. It's just helpful to have a light in front of me pointing at me. It's a bit more of a pain to bring this bar light with me on a trip because I got to bring the stand. And I think I'm going to have to like wrap this, the actual bar light, the light bar, I'm going to have to like wrap in clothing or something like that. Is there any way to have the camera and the arm on one arm stand? You'd have to get some kind of custom stand. It doesn't work with the stands I have. I don't know if somebody makes a stand, but the bar light comes with its own stand. So, but the bar light screws into the stand, I think. So you could probably buy some sort of stand where you can put them both on there. I know what you're saying. It's an interesting idea. Yeah, I don't know. You'd have to have a stand that would have two screw-on things and be able to kind of independently have two things move up or down or something. So I don't know. I see. It's an interesting idea, though, the idea that you'd have one base that could hold two things that would screw into it. But I'd still want to have independent control of the two things. That's the thing. It is annoying to have to bring two stands with two bases, though. Yeah, I use a green screen on the regular channel. But when I'm traveling, I'm not bringing a green screen with me. Hang on, sorry. Oh, my phone started to stop doing that weird thing, which is good, it was doing. The yellow teapot. I think that you can find that on my Amazon links. One of the mods can post. Hey, it's Find It, Fix It. Hello. One of the mods can post the link to the yellow teapot. No, it can post the link to my Amazon links. And then it should be, if you go to my Amazon links, it should be on there somewhere. People always ask about it. One of the viewers gave it to me like 2 years ago. Yeah, hang on a moment here. Yeah, see if you can click on that link that Nightbot just posted via the mods. See if you can find it there. I mean, I think I have it here anyway, but. Trying to. Why is this not working? Why is this not working? Why is it malfunctioning? Let's try this one more time. Okay, there's that. There's the kettle. This, okay, I want, okay, I'll post the link to the yellow kettle again anyway. As an Amazon associate, I earn from qualifying purchases. I just posted it again. Let's see, other comments here. Get some razzle dazzle is here. The blue thing back there is the water, whatever you call it, SodaStream. The SodaStream. The George Foreman grill is back there in the corner, Beaker. I got to get this shirt and tie is annoying me. Hold on 1 second. Give me 1 second here, guys. I got to take off the shirt and tie. It's really driving me crazy. Hang on. Take 2 seconds. It'll take 2 seconds, everyone. Please be patient. Please be patient. I really appreciate everybody's help with the testing. It's really helpful to have you guys giving the feedback and helping me test it out. So I know it actually works for when we need to use it. All right, hang on, I'm just about done. Just about done here. No, seriously, I'm just about done. What I can also do is, hang on. What I can also do is, I have not even gone into the camera settings. I haven't even real. I just opened the camera tonight. Just unboxed it tonight. So I haven't even gone into the camera program, the manufacturer's program, and made some adjustments there. So I could probably do that too. But again, this is the box for the camera. MX Brio. I think they're both keepers. Oh, there's one other thing I want to show you. We have one more thing to try on, to unbox. One more thing to unbox. Here. Also, for work. For work. That is, I got, where is it? I have never owned a rain, well, not since I was a kid. I have never had a raincoat as like an adult. It's a Logitech MX Brio. That's who makes the camera, Logitech MX Brio. So I've never had a raincoat, like a designated raincoat. And I figured, you know, given that I'm going to be, oops, where's the microphone? You can't hear me. I got to put this microphone on. Given that I'm going to be doing, you know, walking around and doing streams, like when I'm in Florida, for example, and I did in Paris, it'd be good to have a raincoat. You just sweat in a raincoat, says Unterman. Well, it keeps you, so I got a raincoat. I got a Columbia raincoat. I ordered a Columbia raincoat from Amazon. Look at this. Look at this, it's a real raincoat. It's called, I have to look up what it's called. Lithicy says Gore-Tex is the way to go. This is a Columbia something or other. I'm going to post the link. Omnitech. No, that's not the name of it. The name of it is a something or other. I'll post the link right now. It is, where is it here? One moment. It is right. Ooh. Columbia Watertight II. It's the men's Watertight II rain jacket. Wirecutter recommended it. It's got some good reviews on Amazon. It's called the Watertight II. So I'm going to post a link to that right now. Columbia Watertight II rain jacket. I just posted the link on YouTube. I'd like to post it on Twitch as well. Then I'm going to try it on. I'm very excited for this. There it is. Wonderful. I'm going to post the link right now on Twitch. Columbia Watertight II rain jacket. As an Amazon associate from qualifying purchases. Lefizzy says, I got a Berghaus one, cost me 170 euros. Wow, this was cheaper than that. Hans Niskatuki says, raincoats keep falling on your head. Somebody said it's breathable. I'm looking it up right now. It says, I don't even know what it says. It says Omnitech. It says waterproof and breathable, supposedly. Waterproof and breathable. Lightweight and packable. The perfect outer layer. An adjustable storm hood. Built to last. All right, so this is waterproof. All right, so I'm gonna try this on. I'm trying this on right now. And I guess I should put it on over my sweatshirt, right? So the inside is like this mesh kind of thing. There's the inside, it's this meshy stuff. All right, does it have a zipper on the front, or is it a pullover? Oh no, look at that, it's got a zipper. That's easy. See, it has Velcro and you can unzip it. Wow, I feel like such an adult. I hope it fits. I have not had a raincoat. It's ridiculous. Is it gonna be too big? It might be too big. Well, I don't know, I got the large because I normally take large. And I the other thing is I'm gonna be wearing stuff under it, but I don't know if I should try the medium. It might be too big. I can't tell. You know, it's hard to say. It's not that big, actually. I mean, I don't know if you guys can see this. The arms are like a little long. They're not that long. It does feel a bit big, but I don't know. I almost want to try the medium. See how the arms are like this? What do you guys think? Hold on, I'm looking up what you're saying. Sorry, I gotta get the stream on my phone. Looks fine. How tall am I? Like normal height. It doesn't look too big. Tight will be uncomfortable. You will need things under it. Because I'm wearing right now a shirt and a sweatshirt. Yeah, I mean, Slug says you might not be able to layer it if you have a medium. Yeah, you will grow into it. Get some Razzle Dazzle says, looks like better a little loose and uncomfortable. I'll have to think about it. I may try the medium and see. Yeah, I am going to try it without the sweatshirt. I should. Because during the summer, I would wear it without the sweatshirt sometimes. That's true. I don't know if it's going to seem too big. Medium will be too small, people think. Oh, these, by the way, you can actually... You know what you can do? I didn't... Look what I did. See this? See how this is too big here? You can actually tighten the sleeves with the Velcro. See this? See, look, I'm tightening the sleeve a little bit with the Velcro. And then once you tighten the sleeve with the Velcro, this is not going over my arm, my hand anymore. That actually is helpful to know, or not as much anymore. Yeah, so that's a little better. That's a little better there. I like that it has pockets. Pockets are good. You know, you probably... It's good to have... I mean, it's a raincoat, so you're going to be wearing it when it's raining. Yeah, I'm guessing... My guess is that a medium will be too small. Oh, people were saying try it without your sweater underneath. Yeah, I got to do that. Let me do that. I don't know, though. I'll have to see. The sleeve tighter will keep water from going down your sleeve while holding the camera. Everybody thinks the medium's going to be too small. Get Some thinks the size looks good for accommodating all possible outfit options. Amazon said, given what I order, it suggested a large. And normally I take large, actually, in most things. Medium might... Hold on. Can you take it to tailor? No, I would just... I mean, I can... Amazon, I could always get the medium from Amazon and try it. It's not that big. It feels bigger because of the sleeves. The sleeves make it feel bigger. That's the thing. That definitely changes how it feels. So if I do tighten the sleeves, it feels a lot less big. I can make the sleeves much tighter. You just use the Velcro. That's how it's looking. Oh, and then you can zip it all the way up, and you can Velcro this part, Velcro all this. That is not bad. Medium will bind the shoulders, thinks Rick Hoppy. Oh, where did I put the microphone? Sorry. Hang on. Now I have the microphone sitting here. I'll put the hood on now. Oh, there's the hood. Hey, look. I'm ready for the rain. Ready for storm chasing. Set it and forget it. Perfect. Slug thinks it's good. It's good to have this, just like if I'm walking around and I think it's going to be a little rainy. I mean, if I'm going to Florida, it could rain. There's definitely places I would go where it might rain. You have to be careful not to catch the inner fly flap in zipper when zipping back down. So easy to do. I do like how light it is. It's very light. This is not heavy. It is a little long. I mean, you know, I guess the thing is, though, it's like, it's not the worst thing that it's a little long if I'm using it to keep myself dry, right? The point of it is to keep yourself dry. This one is for men. I would not be surprised if they make it for women. Are raincoats normally longer? I don't even know this. Like, I look at it and I'm like, oh, it's a little long. But are raincoats normally longer? I never have had a raincoat as an adult. Do people know? Joy says, yes, longer. Slug says, usually. Evelyn says, can be longer. I mean, it makes sense because it's trying to keep you dry. Now you need the pants. Longer keeps water from getting in your pants. Mine is longer, Eddie Bauer. At the bottom, your pants will get wet. It'll keep your pockets dry being longer. The one thing is, there's a couple little threads hanging off here. I don't like that these threads are hanging off. I need to cut off the threads. And cut off these threads. There you go. I cut off the thread. Now I can't even see where it is. Okay, I'm excited about this. I think it's all right. I mean, I really like the idea of it. I just hopefully... if it is too tight, you will sweat. You should cover your behind. Polly says, you sure you didn't select the tall one? Yes, I ordered regular. I ordered regular. I should look inside and make sure they sent me the non-tall one, though. Hang on. Rick said, I used to wear a raincoat, it doesn't fit anymore. A string? I don't see a string on it. I just see... Oops. Sorry. Can you still hear me? Can you still hear me? Okay. You're only going to use it when it rains, not an everyday coat. It is a good point. That's the whole point of it is to use it when it rains. Although, you know, if it's a nice coat, you bring it out with you. It just says large in it. It does not say tall. And I did not order the tall one. Hang on. I'm going to just confirm. Yes, I ordered large, not large tall, just large. Okay, well, yeah, the only thing I could see doing is, you guys are all like, it fits great. Linda Gordon thinks it's good. I'll have to see. I might just get like so antsy about trying the medium that I try the medium and then send back one of them. But I pretty much always take large and stuff like this. That's the thing. I should look up on the reviews what they say, people say about the sizing. One person says they could have gotten away with a medium instead of a large. One person said the large left a little more room for layers, but was too baggy on me when worn without layers. I mean, in theory also, I could even wear it like during the winter. Or, you know, during, definitely during fall and spring. Keep the large so you can comfortably layer a micro fleece under it in chillier weather, says Generse. I definitely think there's something to that. Definitely. BZ says, I'm not sure what the problem is. T-Sky says, reviews say it runs a little big. Mike had feedback. Oh, Mike had feedback on the raincoat. Oric thinks the medium will be too tight. Yeah, everybody seems to think I should keep the large. I mean, it wasn't like crazy fitting. It was just a bit big fitting. It'll shrink when you wear it. I don't think it would because that it's not like of that fabric. I don't think it will. Keep the grande, says Rob. But it's light. Also, this won't take up too much space in my luggage. 98% of chatters agree. All right, so that's good. That's good. Okay, so that's done. Linda says, keep the large, you won't get wet. In a week, I'm going to Florida for a little bit. Going to Florida and going to do some streams there and bring my laptop so I can cover news. You can put the light in the rain jacket. It depends. I'll have to figure out how I'm going to pack the light up and everything. Some Miami and some Key West. Some Miami and some Key West. That's where we're going. So we'll be doing some streams from there. I will not be going to Mar-a-Lago. Thanks to all of our moderators who've been moderating, by the way. I really appreciate it. David Green and Kay and Beezy and Ruben Urban and who else has been there? I'm forgetting. Cynthia Moon. I think I'm missing mods. Sarah, Raven Riley, AJ. I'm looking forward to having some Cuban sandwiches. Meg Sweet says, Darren, good idea to look for pull strings on jacket, inside or outside. Are there pull strings on this jacket? I did not see any pull strings. Oh, wait, there's this thing at the bottom. There's this thing on the bottom of the jacket, there's this string thing. So I assume you could pull the bottom kind of shut, maybe. There is this pull thing. It's right on the bottom of the jacket. And then there is, I'm looking here. I think the hood has one too. Maybe? What is the thing with the string? Maybe it runs all around the jacket. How do you do that? What do you do? Oh, you pull it? I don't even know how you use the pull string. I don't know how you use this thing. I see this thing right here. You pull it through the holes, is that what you do? You press this and, yeah, you pull it. I see, I got it. Now I know how to use it, I see. So what does the string do? It just makes everything tighter. Oh, it makes the bottom tighter, right? Makes it tighter around your waist or something. Yeah, it's definitely tighter around my waist now. Does it make the hood tighter too, or not? I don't know if there's a pull string for the hood. There may be. I don't know. Oh, there is one for the hood. No, is this for the hood, or is this one? I can't tell if the one up here is connected to the one down here, if there's just one or two. This thing's all... Anyways, though, I can say that the string... Sorry, I'm trying not to zip this all the way up because then the mic won't work. But I pulled this tighter down here, and it definitely got tighter around my waist, which was lovely. String is good in Miami. Just watch for storms, says Linda. But that pull string definitely made the waist tighter. There's usually one for the hood. There's definitely a string in there. I don't know where the pull thing is, though. Oh, is this it? No. Cinch it to keep the snow out. So I can tell you there is a string that goes around the hood. I just don't know where the end of it is, unless it's connected to the one at the bottom. Is that possible that the string is connected to the one at the bottom? I think it might be. Yeah, because I think it goes from the top to the bottom. It's kind of neat, though. Yeah, that's better. Definitely better down at the waist. Then the sleeves are better when you tighten them up. Yeah, that's not bad. Hold on, I'm turning the whole thing up. Now you can't hear me. That's not too bad right there. I have a sweater on underneath. Anyways. Why have a warm jacket in Miami? This isn't a warm jacket. It's a rain jacket. It's a light rain jacket. You need that in pants, says Lori. All right. Well, I'm not totally convinced the medium would be too small, but it's very possible the medium would be too small. Looks like you're ready to do some live reporting for the hurricane, says Scouse. The string for the hood cinches it around your face. Again, I see a string going around the hood, and oh, no. The string from the hood runs from the hood through here, and... It goes down to, I think it goes down to the bottom. I don't know. It seems like maybe it does. Where does it go? Hold on. No, let me sec. Here's the other side of the hood string. I can't find it. I don't know where it is. I see the string going around the hood, guys. But I don't know how you adjust it, if it's its own adjustment. Inside pockets? I don't know. Who knows? Who knows how this thing works? I need a manual for the jacket. Not going to worry about it right now. The point is, at least I have a jacket I can wear. It says hood and bottom have adjustable pull string. Also comes with strings you can pull down to tighten the hood and not let the wind blow it over. The hood does have a string to tighten the hood. Okay, so people are saying the hood has its own string. So weird. Again, I can see the string. I just can't see the... There's no sign of a thing to pull it. It's a mystery. It's a mystery, everyone. It's a giant mystery. Those nubs, pinch them to release after you tighten. These nub things. These nubs you don't pinch. These are they're these nub things, but I don't think you can. Oh yes, that's it. That's what it is. It's these nub things. Our viewer's a genius. Those little things, there's two of those, there's these things on either side. Maggie N got it. They're these little nub things. So I guess you can use those nub things to tighten the hood. You pull them both, says Red Squirrel. All right, so the two nub things are here and here. There's one here and one here. You pull the nub things? That's not the one. The one at the bottom doesn't work like that, just the one at the top. Sorry, the microphone is probably muted. But where is the... All right, so here are the two... Pinch them and pull. Here's one. Where's the other one? There's the other one. Pinch them and pull? That doesn't seem to work. I can pull down that way. I can do one of each, pull each one separately. This one's like a difficult. Can't even feel it. Well, I think it's all mixed up. There's the top one. Here it is. Pull and slide back. Can't tell if I'm doing it right. So hard. Hold the nub and pull the string. That's what I thought. But people aren't saying that though. Pull the two strings straight down. If you pull down, it doesn't really do anything because it's not gonna pull these things. Yeah, I think you can pull the strings down through the nub. That's what you can do. See this? Look, I just pulled the string down. That definitely tightens it. That definitely does it. For each string, you pull the string down and you squeeze the nub. And then when you want to loosen it, you can squeeze the nub and pull the string up, I think. If you can grab the string. Yes, that's how you do it. Well, it's how I can do it, at least. It seemed to work for me. Yeah. Okay. Wow. Steve learns how to use a rain jacket. All right, who knows? Maybe when I, maybe I'll try the, you're gonna hate me. Part of me still thinks I should try the medium. I don't know why people are so anti trying the medium. Seems like people are very angry about that idea. They're very angry about it. Mimi says, order the medium, then keep the one that fits better. I mean, I'm not going to use them both, but... Rob says, have both to cover all situations. T-Sky says, you won't have layers in Florida. Maybe you could wear them both. Kay says, try both. I'll probably have to try both. I probably will. Your butt will get wet in a medium? Kinetic thinks my butt will get wet in the medium, guys. Jimmy says, I'm always torn between a medium and a large. Unleashed flute in hands. Niskatuki are watching over there on Twitch. Yeah, I'll probably have to... tried. Hey, thanks, Desi Des. I appreciate that, Desi Des. Thank you. Medium will constrain you, says Craig. It will be hard to bend. Yeah, a lot of you guys are saying, like, you want the large for a raincoat. See, that's the thing, is that I'm not used to wearing a raincoat. And it's entirely possible that for a raincoat, you want it to be, like, just on the bigger side. John says medium will ride up when you sit down. That's an interesting point. A very interesting point. This is not that big. I'm worried. But the thing I worry about is it's something you wear during summer with, say, a t-shirt, right? I'm not going to be wearing a sweatshirt underneath this. If I'm wearing it in Miami, I'm going to be wearing a t-shirt. Who's wearing a sweatshirt running around Florida? You know? Yeah, I could wear it in the winter with more stuff under it. That is true. That's not, you're not wrong. There it is again. Here it is again. Lego Mike says, can we just buy something and be happy the first time, please? Well, it's hard to do the, it's hard with sizes. Darren says it's about how it works to keep the rain off you. It's not like comically big. It is roomy a bit, but it's not comically big. It's comfortable. I will say this, it is not constraining. It is definitely not constraining. You know, and that there is definitely something to be said for not constraining you, and you're not feeling your arms restricted. You know, that is a good thing. That my guess is that if I agree with the people who say, if my guess is that if I got a medium, I would feel my arms constrained, because that gets really annoying. I do agree with you there. Constrain. Oh, thanks to Meg Sweet B. Thank you so much, Meg Sweet B. That's so nice of you. Thank you. Thank you very much. Yeah, this kind of fabrics too does not have give. So if it's a little tight, you will be feeling it. Kinetic says, I wear them when I work outside and bigger is better. So yeah, I have a feeling this is the one. I know it feels a little on the big side, but I think the lack of constraints is definitely something that's a good thing. Chucky's Chicklet thinks it looks like a perfectly sized raincoat. Red Squirrel says definitely the large. All right, I'm. It's good to have a raincoat. It's big enough to hide something underneath, inside it, from the rain. What am I going to be hiding underneath it? Stop by Kentucky for the Derby on my way home. Unfortunately, I don't think I'm going to be able to, but oh, I can do this now. Covering the weather? Well, I don't cover the weather outside. Raven Riley thinks it's perfect. Yeah, I mean, this is again, the lack of constraints is good, because I need to feel free. I need to feel free. I will be covering the eclipse on Monday, assuming I can get footage from Reuters. Annie Kush says, be free. God is my banner says, yay, decision made. For now, the decision is made. But I do need one of these. It would have been good to have one of these in Paris when I was walking around. Because if you think it might be raining out, it's like none of the jackets I have is waterproof. This is waterproof. Rick Hoppy says, just what I said, a man's got to be free. Okay. Oh, my battery's going to run down anyway. Hold on. I might have to plug the phone in shortly. Well, I think shortly we're going to wrap this up anyway. What did you do to manage in the rain till now? Well, I would like wear an umbrella. Oh, no, I would hold an umbrella. It feels nice. I gotta say, this jacket though, it actually feels very comfortable. It feels nice on the inside. I'm wearing it with a t-shirt. Can you remove the hood? No. But it's light. I like it. I'm a fan. What I'm gonna do though is I'm gonna just post that link again. Can't get this on my shirt. There we go. I'm going to post the link again. Sorry. Can any of the mods post the link again? Is that easy to do? Chucky's says, I have this exact same one and I love it. I even use it in the winter sometimes when it's raining. Oh, thanks, Red Squirrel. Thanks. No, I'm looking forward to doing the eclipse stream. Thank you, Red Squirrel. I appreciate that. Yeah, I just posted it again in the YouTube in the YouTube chat as an Amazon associate for qualifying purchases. But I just posted it again. I think in Twitch you should be able to find. If you go back, you should be able to find it in the chat. I did post it in Twitch. Where is it there? Well, I practice Spanish in Florida. I don't think so. I don't know though. We'll see. Yeah, on Twitch you can go back in the chat and see it. An itinerary, not really. Just if we're going to spend half the time in Miami and half in Key West. JBN Jive says, "Are you in the hood?" No, I'm going to be in Boston for the eclipse, and I'm going to do a live stream on Agenda Free TV. Is the mic weatherproof? Says Craig Nidal. I don't believe the mic is made to be weatherproof. My guess is that maybe it can handle a little bit of moisture, but I don't think it's certainly not made to be. I don't think it's made to be like you can dunk it in something or something like that. So I don't believe. But I've used it like when it was drizzling out and I haven't had problems. Thanks, Craig. Yeah, the mic is called the DJI mic. It's a wireless microphone. I use it with my phone. DJI mic. I think if somebody posts my, if one of the mods can post my Amazon favorite things list again, it should be on there somewhere. DJI mic. But there's now a new version of it, actually. But the old version is good and it's cheaper, too. So they're both good versions. I have both of them. There's the DJI mic 2 in the original DJI mic. As an Amazon associate, I am for qualifying purchases. Tuts Mom says, love Cuban sandwiches. All right. Anyways. But yeah, if you like stream on your phone, having these like wireless mics, there's a receiver that plugs into the phone, and then you get two of these transmitters. And so it's really good. And then if you have two people on the stream, you can give them both a microphone. Okay, it's a wireless mic. A wireless mic with a receiver. I think this one runs, this set, it's not cheap. What is it, $249? You get a charging case, and then the new one is $349. But I actually own both of them because I use them all the time. The new one is noise cancellation. But for me, I use them all the time. And I use them in here, too. Whenever I'm on my phone, even inside when I'm in like the kitchen, I use them. And I use them when I travel all the time. The fluffy thing is just a windscreen that comes with it that you can put on when you're outside. All right, I think it may be our time. This has been quite the stream. We tried out the really cool, I really am a big fan of this light here. I'm actually using it right now still. The Litra Beam light by Logitech. If you're watching on YouTube, link is in the description. Twitch, I posted it earlier. That's the Litra Beam light. I'm going to bring that with me to use for Agenda Free TV streams on the road. Then we also I'm quite happy with it. This is the camera. I have a privacy screen shut now, but you can open and shut that. That's the MX Brio. It's the new Logitech camera they came out with. Link in the description on YouTube. So that's good. We tried those out. We seem to get a fairly decent picture. for our test agenda-free TV stream on the laptop when there was no other lights on except for that one light. And we tried on the raincoat. We did a bunch of things. So, good. Wonderful. So I think we're going to wrap up this stream, but more streams to come, more news and more of these streams. Tomorrow is Friday? Yes. The Iowa-Connecticut game should be especially good tomorrow. I bet a lot of people are going to watch that. I'm going to watch that. More streams. Let's see here. But I appreciate you all being here. This was fun. And thanks for all of your help with the jacket and trying the camera and the lighting and the light. I appreciate your help with it all. Oh, Gossamer was here. Hey, let's thank our moderators. Sarah, who else? Ruben Urban, David Green, Kay, Raven Riley, Beezy, Cynthia Moon, AJ. Thank you, moderators. Again, look at the difference. Even this, having this light here when I'm just using the phone, it's such a difference. That's without the light on. That's how I normally would be in here. But I just had this light out here, so I put it on for the stream. It does make a significant difference. I got that fire. Are you in Florida? I got that fire. Yeah, let me know. A couple of our viewers are in Florida. You should send me an email. I got that fire. Like agendafreetv@gmail.com. Maybe I'll do one time where I can meet a couple of the viewers. I don't know what my schedule is yet. But it's better if you, probably better if you send me an email at agendafreetv@gmail.com. Cool. Great. Kinetic says, I will be there for the Iowa Kinetic game. Hey, thanks for everybody. A lot of you gave like gift memberships and stuff. That was really nice of you and people who donated. Hopefully I got everybody and thanked everybody when they did it, but I appreciate that very much. Beezy's in Florida, but on the wrong coast. I know Connie Fernandez is there. Louise says, anybody who does not have that jacket should consider getting one. I love mine and I've had it for years. Kiwi says, pray for rain so you can test the raincoat. Thanks, Wickedest Witch, for watching. Louise, God is my banner. Beaker McGillicuddy. Kinetic. Chucky's Chicklet. Lego Mike. Crazy Auto. Crazy Auto thinks UConn's going to barely break a sweat. Winning? Wow. Rick Hoppy, Gas on the Brain. Evelyn in Maine. K9 Striker. Oh yeah, notifications. Sign up for the Discord notifications. Those are the best notifications. The mods will post the link to the Discord notifications. Those work the best. Sign up for those. It's free for both channels, for Agenda Free TV and Lookner. Hey, thanks, Annie Kush. A birthday shout out to, was it Texas Snack Pack's birthday? Happy birthday, Texas Snack Pack. Watching over there on Twitch. Hope you have a good birthday. Evelyn in Maine, thanks for watching. Kariba Guyan, Dr. McRib, Rob Zoso, D-Tops, Buddha Belly, Gardening with Susie, Marge, Gossamer, Meg Swede, Teresa Mice, Marissa Pugliese, Polly, Rosemary Randolph, William Cromer, Rick says, I'd rather have a Cuban cigar, but I'd have to go to Cuba for that. Lori from Boston. Cynthia. Shauna. Joyce. All right, guys, wrapping it up. If there's big news tonight and I'm awake, I'll come on the air for that. But I really appreciate it. Oh, J-A-N-P. Thanks, J-A-N-P, for modding, too. Thanks, guys. Thanks for all your help tonight. It was really nice of you to help out. Thanks, Randy S. Looking forward to using this stuff when we travel. And I'll use the jacket and the light and the camera. I'm planning on bringing it all with me. All right. Thanks, guys. Wrapping it up. And we will see you very soon.